What's up, crew? It's your boy, Steph, and back at you with another video. Whew, I said that weird. We're gonna open up some pallets this week. Make sure you subscribe to this channel. Once I hit 3,000 subs, I'm giving away a bunch of stickers. Supreme stickers. But if you ask me and you're the winner, I can go ahead and throw in some palace stickers like we got in this bag from the palace drop. What is this week for the palace? I can't even remember. Is this week 7? Week 6? Oh my goodness. Actually, this is from week 9. So I'm a little bit behind, but you know, we did get a Tri Ferg sticker. We have some receipt information in here. And then we have our palace tee, nice and gray. Went for that medium size for more summer fit. I got a couple of dark ones from Palace, so now I need to get some lighter color ones. This gray one will be perfect. It won't really go with my new dunks I just got. What do you guys think? You guys like these dunks? They're actually not new. These are pretty old, but they're in really good condition. You can still see the logo on the inside of the insole. I mean, I already did wear them longboarding quite a bit, so they're a little bit wore out. And the toe box, I kind of messed up a little bit. I think I already creased them a bit from just longboarding. I mean, these are skateboard shoes, essentially, I think, anyways. So that's what I'm gonna do in them. Well, I'm gonna longboard because I don't really skateboard anymore. I just kind of lost the urge once longboarding became a thing and just the relaxing part of it. And even when I was younger, it was more about just skateboarding fast. It wasn't about tricks for me, which is weird. It should have been about tricks, but it wasn't. So, I mean, I have great balance. I mean, excellent balance, but yeah, for tricks, no, not so great. Let me put these back on. Okay, let's go ahead and show this sticker on there. We got our little label sticker. Tri Ferg right on the front. All of our warning information on the back. Now, let's break into this. All right, inside we do have a piece of tissue paper and a moisture reducer thing. And there's our graphic. I like this gray one because of that green snake, the red barbed wire. I mean, come on. That is solid. And a little tiny one up front. This shirt is a very standard size medium, maybe a tiny bit oversized. I actually have a bunch of medium sized shirts I just bought, a bunch of organic ones. These are all made in Mexico in a well cared for factory with good employees, you know, that are happy working there. So these are very eco-friendly. They are kind of pricey, but I did buy a bunch of them so that I could paint on them and be able to give them to you guys, sell them to you guys for a decent price so you guys can have some original artwork and not be worried about where your garments were made. You can check out the website of this company if you'd like, so you can know exactly what you're buying when you order from my personal art collection. But yeah, so this one is about that same size. It's maybe a little bit wider up top, but other than that, it's basically a standard size medium. So let's go ahead and I'll throw it on. Okay, yeah, for sure. This shirt be great for a summer fit, looks amazing. You got that amazing graphic, obviously. The fit is just, like I said, true to size for a size medium, maybe a tiny bit oversized, but not really. It's basically just a size medium, but nothing like a foreign medium or anything, very just American size medium. And yeah, those logos on there, just so solid. Gotta love that. But anyways, I am gonna shoot some positivity at you guys. I've been going over some different Old Testament stuff in the Bible because, I mean, I was raised reading that thing. The Bible, I mean, doing book reports, and went to 8 years of different Bible colleges. Well, 4 years at one college and 2 years at another, 1 year at another, 1 year at a different one. So I have a very rounded knowledge and very diverse knowledge of the scriptures. And I continue to learn from the different amazing minds we out there who study ancient Near East and study just the culture back then. So you get a really good understanding of what these texts mean, because a lot of people out there, I'm not gonna call anybody out, but there's a lot of people out there who are just spewing this rhetoric of follow me or your life is gonna be bad, or they're gonna say follow me or the afterlife when you die is gonna be horrendous. And they're just using all this fear talk to try and convince us that we need to follow their way of thinking and their lifestyle and align with their culture. I don't agree. That's what Jesus came to do. He came to liberate us. He came to set us free so we can be artistic. I'm a very artistic person. I really love to show my emotions through music and through different forms of art, painting, things like that. And so having these restraints on me has really made me feel just trapped in a way. But with all this knowledge I've gained, I've actually deciphered the truth that's been hidden behind all these legalistic lies that are built up in the Western fundamentalist Christianity. And to be free from those things is just so liberating. It's amazing because you just love everything and everyone out there because the love of God is just amazing. It's just unending. He just lets everybody just do whatever they feel they need to. And it goes kind of weird because then people use their free will to try and control massive groups of people, which I think is not a good thing to do. But I mean, I live in this country where we have a very large government. So, I mean, I can't really speak anything different because I don't know much different than just mass control. Anyways, I'm going to the story of Noah in the Old Testament. It was very, very early in the book. And this was Moses who actually wrote this. Moses wrote the whole first five books of the Bible known as the Torah. Moses may not have been the author, but many people credit him to be the author. And I mean, there's no one really we could think of, so why not just give him the credit? It all has similar writing styles, plus he was an educated Egyptian, you know, Hebrew brought up in the Egyptian world. You can watch The Prince of Egypt, right? The Disney movie kind of gives you an idea of how Moses might have been raised. I mean, kind of, not really, obviously. But anyways, Moses wrote the story of Noah because there was this mass flood that happened on the earth, and it did a lot of changing of cultures and of different continents, and just everything, life in general, was really affected. And so he showed that the way that their lineage had carried on past that flood, past that massive natural destruction, was this man named Noah and his way of living, and he brought in this whole story with all this amazing emotion and really pulls you in. Moses wanted to show the Israelites that the God who wants us to care for all those around us, love everyone, he wanted to show that those people that followed after God did not die out. They're still here. We're still flourishing. This is our lineage. We carried on because God wanted us to. He wanted us to carry on this message of acceptance and equality. And Moses was really far away from equality, even in his own thinking. He had some stuff he needed to change. So, I mean, you can't take everything he says and writes as being 100% how you should live your life, because he lived in a very different time. We know a lot more now, and we know how we can treat people even better now than he knew back then. So, I say, let's do everything we can now to make the most of each moment. Whenever you're out and about and you have a communication with somebody, try and make it more positive instead of dragging them down. I mean, if they're bringing up some crazy conversation, political or spiritual or whatever it is, I mean, you can kind of dive into it and just share as much as they're willing to accept. Don't over bombard, because that can really make people be pushed away, and I've really learned that. So now I have to be really extra gentle with people because I want them to feel comfortable coming to me and sharing their experience or their thoughts about different topics. So I like to be really well-rounded. So if you guys have any comments you want to share with me, definitely hit me up. You can comment down below on this video. You can message me on my social media stuff. I love to have some good conversation, but also remember, I'm working 60 hours a week, it seems like, plus doing some of these videos, plus posting stuff online, plus trying to figure out what new hype stuff is out there that I can grab. So it's a busy life. It'd be really cool if you guys want to share some podcasts with me. I love that. I listen to podcasts like none other. So anyways, I love y'all. Peace.